scaling in electrostatic forces. So for this, let us consider two parallel electric conductive plates charged by a voltage V, which produces electric potential field. The corresponding potential energy is given by U is equal to minus 1 by 2 CV square, which is equal to minus epsilon naught epsilon r WL by 2D into V square, where epsilon naught epsilon r are the permittivity and W is the width, L is the length and D is the gap between the two plates, and where V is the potential energy or the voltage. Now this equation we need to consider, and whatever parameters are present in this equation, we need to relate them with the linear dimension of the plates. So let us consider small l as the linear scale of the electrodes or the linear dimension. Then you have epsilon naught and epsilon r having neutral effect, that is epsilon naught and epsilon r directly proportional to l raised to 0, and W, L and D are directly proportional to L. So that means, is the linear dimension, if it is decreased by 1 unit, W, L and D also will decrease by 1 unit, or if L linear dimension is increased by 1 unit, W, L and D also will be increased by 1 unit. So we can say that W, L and D are directly proportional to L raised to 1. And once more is there that V, voltage V, what about V, for that we need to consider Paschen's effect. He has illustrated that, if you say, take this graph, you will understand it clearly. So he has taken a graph between the voltage and the gap. So as you see, when the gap is at 5 micrometer, from 0 to 5 micrometer, if you see, the voltage will drastically decrease. If you see at from 5 micrometer to 10 micrometer, slightly decreases. But after 10 micrometer, if you see the voltage, it slightly rises, and it's almost constant, or you can say slightly rises, linearly it rises after 10 micrometer. From that, he has taken and has given that V is directly proportional to L raised to 1. It means again, if linear dimension is increased by 1 unit, voltage also will be increased by 1 unit. Or if linear dimension is decreased by 1 unit, voltage also will be decreased by 1 unit. So taking all these into consideration, if you want to know what is the scaling of potential energy, then you have to consider the equation U is equal to minus epsilon naught epsilon r WL by 2D into V square, and make that L, you need to find the relation between the U and L. So you will get U is directly proportional to L cube. So if you solve that, L raised to 1, L raised to 1 get cancels, L raised to 1 into L raised to square, you will get L raised to 3. So the final equation is U is directly proportional to L cube. This is the scaling equation. So from that you can say a 10 time reduction of linear size of electrodes will lead to 1000 times reduction in the potential energy. So this is about potential energy. Next you have electrostatic forces. So for that you need to consider electrostatic forces in misaligned electrodes. So you can see here FD, FW and FL are the three electrostatic forces. So FD is related to the gap D, and FW is related to the width, FL is related to the length. For this also you have the three equations. Again, same procedure we need to do. Epsilon naught, epsilon r, W, L, V and D, it is related to L. The same equations you need to take, and you need to find out what is the relation between F and small l. So ultimately you get FD, FW and FL directly proportional to L square. So this is the scaling equation here. So we can say that a 10 time reduction in the electrode linear dimension will lead to 100 times or 10 square, 100 times reduction in the magnitude of the electrostatic force. So in this topic, mainly two equations. One is U directly proportional to L cube, and FD, FW and FL directly proportional to L square. That are the two equations which you need to remember.